Hello friends. In this lesson, let's examine the technical data reports of digital tachographs. We will examine what information is in technical data reports, how to read this information, how to interpret it, what information will be suspected by the inspector. Technical data report of the tachograph you see on the screen. Owned by the Stornage brand. Same for all brands. I assume you know the symbols in the report. So let's start reading. Technical data report, obtained on the 15th of March 2018 at 7:25 UTC time. The name and surname of the driver who brought the vehicle for calibration is Unalison. Vehicle icon, the vehicle's chassis number and license plate. This section contains the information of the company that produces the tachograph device. Shows the serial numbers of the tachograph. In this section, there is information about the sensor working with the tachograph, the number of the sensor and the date of manufacture. There are two types of sensors. These are continent 1 and continent 2. The difference between them is that they are affected by the magnet. That is, they are affected by the magnetic field. According to EC 1266/2009, the serial number of the Continent 1 sensor is below 10 million, and the Continent 2 has a serial number of over 10 million. Tachographs manufactured or installed after the 1st of November 2011 must have a two-version sensor. In this section, there is the name of the service that calibrates the tachograph, the card number and the validity date of the card. The date of the first trial calibration, the chassis number of the vehicle, the license plate of the vehicle, the place with a question mark indicates that the license plate is not defined. Now we come to the important points. W, K, L and wheel icon. Let's learn the meanings and functions of these symbols. The W data indicates the number of revolutions of the gearbox. The product of the number of revolutions of the gearbox multiplied by the measurement of the wheel circumference in millimeters will also give us the distance and speed of the vehicle. K data is generally the same as W data. However, it may be different if an apparatus is attached to the transmission in old model vehicles. An important situation is that what these data should be is not available in a written source. The data here is determined by the service. The service that calibrates the vehicle detects these data by moving the vehicle on a 20-meter track. Manipulation can be done by increasing these data. And this manipulation is done. L is the measurement of the outer circumference of the wheel in millimeters. The circle icon is the wheel size. The wheel size must match the data on the calibration certificate. If the wheels are replaced with a different size version, a recalibration must be performed. And we see that the speed is set to 89 km per hour. If a different number is entered in the speed data here, for example a speed of 120 to 150, then the speed contract cannot be seen in the tachograph reports. That would be manipulation. Now we see the next calibration. We see that the data in calibration number 1 and 2 are the same. Now the fourth calibration is done. Calibrations 1 and 2 are made for adjustment. The fourth calibration is the last and valid calibration. Let's see if the numbers change. Yes, there is. W data increased from 9166 to 9190. The L data, the measurement of the tire outer circumference, has not changed. And recalibrated in 2016. Because the two-year calibration period is over. A new calibration is required. We are checking the W, K, L data to see if there is any change. No, we see that the data is the same as 2 years ago. So, is this normal? So is it normal for the data between the two calibrations to be the same? When should these data change? Let's consider this issue. Data between two calibrations may differ slightly. Such as 5, 10, 15, it's normal. Because the transmission may be worn or the wheels may be worn. Or the wheels may be renewed. No more changes therefore. For example, a value such as the number 1000 does not change. When will there be a big change in these values? Answer: if the vehicle's transmission changes, if the wheel sizes change, then there can be a big difference in the numbers. If this situation has occurred, then this situation must be proven with a document. We have come to the end of the technical data report. We see that the transactions are done correctly. No changes were made in the last two calibrations. 1 minute timer has been set. Now let's see another report where the data is different. In this report, while the W data was 7465 in the calibration No. 1 dated the 11th of October, 2017, the W data was 10,500 in the calibration No. 2 dated the 30th of September, 2019. The measurement of the tire outer circumference, that is, the L data has been increased from 3,320 to 3,361. So here is a really high number change, like 3,000, is it normal? First of all, such a report should be well studied. We should know if it is being manipulated through technical data. We made the necessary examination, and we saw that the chassis numbers of the vehicle were different. Here we see that the tachograph has changed vehicles. A second-hand tachograph is fitted to the vehicle. If the chassis numbers were the same in this report, that is, if the data had been so different in the same vehicle, manipulation would have been made. We have developed a calculation method to find out whether changes in WKL values are legal or not. Let's find out now. Now let's see another report where the data is different. In this report, while the W data was 7465 in the calibration No. 1 dated the 11th of October, 2017, the W data was 10,500 in the calibration No. 2 dated the 30th of September, 2019. The measurement of the tire outer circumference, that is, the L data has been increased from 3,320 to 3,361. So here is a really high number change, like 3,000, is it normal? First of all, such a report should be well studied. We should know if it is being manipulated through technical data. We made the necessary examination, and we saw that the chassis numbers of the vehicle were different. Here we see that the tachograph has changed vehicles. A second-hand tachograph is fitted to the vehicle. If the chassis numbers were the same in this report, that is, if the data had been so different in the same vehicle, manipulation would have been made. We have developed a calculation method to find out whether changes in WKL values are legal or not. Let's find out now. The operation to be done is to multiply the W data with the L data and note the first four digits of the result. Then we will multiply the W data from the modified second calibration with the L data and get the first four digits of the result. And subtract the result of the two operations from each other. Let's see the report again to remember the numbers. We are going to multiply 7465 by 3320. I note the first four digits of the result. I do the same for the second calibration. And subtract the results from each other. If the result of this process is greater than 60, it means that there is manipulation here. Now let's look at the other report where the data is changed smaller and do the same here again. Here is the process. Here the result was found as 8. Since this figure is less than 60, we can say that there is no problem in calibration. Let's learn one last thing and finish today's lesson. IMS off, IMS on. IMS stands for data validation from ABS. That is, it is the second data source. IMS must be turned on. Closing the IMS means preparing for manipulation. According to the legal regulation, IMS must be open. Yes guys, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.